Good evening and welcome back to Twin State Sports. I'm Zach Siminar. The Ole Miss Rebels are more than 80% of the way through spring ball after wrapping up practice number 12 on Tuesday afternoon. Rebels are now just 3 days out from the annual Grove Bowl, while which is set for Saturday at 3 p.m. from Vaughn Hemingway Stadium. There's tons of intrigue, including a battle at quarterback that will unfold in front of your very eyes on Saturday afternoon. Out is Jordan Tamu, and in is presumed starter Matt Corral. Saturday's Grove Bowl can be seen on the SEC Network. The Ole Miss Rebel softball team struck early to put away the Belmont Lady Bruins in a non-conference showdown in Nashville, Tennessee yesterday. Rebels' big inning came in the third when they roared to six runs and route to an 11-1 win in five innings. Brittany Finney and Amanda Roth each homered and drove in a pair in the win. It gets the Lady Rebs to 25-9 overall. They've now won three in a row. They'll look to extend that streak on Friday when they open up a three-game set with 22nd-ranked Kentucky. Amid an excellent season behind the plate, Rebels junior Cooper Johnson has been named to the Buster Posey Award watch list. Previously named after Johnny Bench, the Buster Posey Award is given to the nation's top catcher in Division I. Johnson has hit .291 for Ole Miss this season, collecting 10 extra base hits. But his best work? It's come with a mask on, where he's erased 10 would-be base stealers. Semifinalists for the award will be announced on May the 17th. Mississippi State Bulldogs, Ole Miss Rebels, and the rest of the SEC, for that matter, may soon have their hands full with the Texas A&M Aggies. A&M has announced their intentions to hire Buzz Williams to be their next men's head basketball coach. Williams has ties to A&M, where he was an assistant for the Aggies from 2004 to 2006. He's been the head coach at Virginia Tech the past 5 years, which included three trips to the Big Dance. For that, led Marquette to the tournament 5 of his 6 years with the Golden Eagles. Hall of Famer and longtime Atlanta Braves manager Bobby Cox has been admitted to an Atlanta area hospital. 77-year-old was admitted with undisclosed medical issues on Tuesday, just a day after Cox wore his Braves jersey while shouting play ball before the Braves home opener against the Cubs back on Monday. Braves manager Brian Snitker spoke to the media today, recognizing that he reached out to Cox's family and said they're very concerned.
Stunned, I guess, reaction. He's holding up great, as Bobby would. I mean, he's a strong man. He's very determined. He's got a strong will. You know, it's just something right now that we're all just doing a lot of praying, and they're...
Oklahoma City Thunder star Russell Westbrook had a historic game against the Lakers last night, accomplishing a feat that only one other player in the history of the NBA had ever done before. By the time the dust settled on the Thunder's win over LA, Westbrook had 20 points, 20 rebounds, and 21 assists, joining the great Wilt Chamberlain as the only players to ever put together a 20-20-20 stat line. Westbrook is also just three assists shy of averaging a triple-double for the third consecutive NBA season.